Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to make a character speak. It's important to know how to create custom animations by hand before using plugins, such as Character Animate, that will create them for you automatically. Understanding the underlying technicalities helps build a solid foundation for your animation skills. We have a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so I've built this character using basic shape layers. As you can see here, I've already kind of parented some of these things to the appropriate layers. Our face layer is our main layer that we want to be able to move around and have everything else follow it. I've created this eyes layer here, and I want to make my character blink and make sure your anchor point is in the center of this layer right here. Hit S to bring up our scale. Go to about 1 second and click on our stopwatch for scale. So make sure you unclick the width and height controls, so that way they can move independently. Page down 2 times, go for 2 frames, and make our height 0. Page down 2 more times, make this 100. And I like my blinks to occur about every 3 seconds, but it's up to you. You can make it more frequent or less frequent. So if I go to about 4 seconds here, just put another keyframe, make sure it's at 100, 100. And I'm on a max, so let's option click scale and hit this little arrow here. Go to property and bring up loop out cycle. And as you can see, it will blink here initially, and then also at the 4 second mark, at the 7 second mark, it will blink again, and the 10 second and so on. So this character will blink every 3 seconds for infinity using this little expression right here. One of the things I created is this color control. And this is something that I've created in a previous tutorial, as well as how to create a character face. So if you're unfamiliar with how to do that, you can look back through my previous episodes and check out those videos as well. I highly recommend that you create a color control layer. And this is just an adjustment layer. If you click on that, we can see here are color controls. The way I created those with this layer highlighted, go to Effect, Expression Controls, and Color Control. And then all I did was I just renamed this to the appropriate layer that I want to be able to adjust. This makes it super easy if you want to change certain things about your character. If you want to make his hair a different color, you can make his skin slightly different, you know, change the low light as well, and change his pupil color, maybe give him some blue eyes, or black pupils. If you want to go pupil or iris, however you want to do it, that looks pretty good right there. And then you'll see also I have this layer for lip color. And this is relevant to our mouth movement. If you lock this down up here, see this little lock here. When you click away, you can still see this. So let's go to mouth movements. And as you can see, that's our lip color. And also this is our skin low light. If we wanted to change our lip color, for example, as you can see, it automatically updates like that. Speaking of mouth movements, since we are in here, there are only about 9 or 10 mouth movements that you really need in order to be able to make a character speak. You can actually do fewer. I like to err on the side of having more precise movements, but you can certainly do less than this. I have a total of 11, as you can see, and these represent most mouth shapes that you'll need in order to make your character speak. The trick to doing this is to make each one of these mouth shapes only 1 frame each, with the exception of the first one, your resting mouth. I like to make this 2 frames, and I'll explain why in just a second. And so let's go back to our main comp. All we have to do is drag in our mouth movements comp here. Remember our position and scale to kind of get this where it looks right. And I need to increase the size of this. So let's rasterize this pre-comp here. Since these are shape layers, you can make this any size and you won't lose any sharpness. So just kind of scroll through here and you want to make sure that your mouth is in about the right spot. And you can always go back into your pre-comp and say, like, for example, if you want this mouth movement to be a little bit lower, push this down a little bit. And we go back. So see, that may actually be a little bit better. Right click, go to time and enable time remapping. And then you can go ahead and get rid of this second keyframe and just drag this out for the length of your comp here. The way this works is whatever frame you choose is going to be the frame that is relevant to your mouth shape. And so this is the reason why I made my resting mouth 2 frames. Now let's pull this up here so that way we can kind of see this as we're editing our guy talking. Now for our resting mouth, it actually begins at frame 0. So if we click 0, we can see that that's our resting mouth, but also so is 1. I like to have that 2 frames just because it will correspond now with your layer number. So say you want, hey, A or I, you can click 2 now. And then if you want to do E or K, you can click 3. And now see if that resting mouth layer was only one frame, then it would be more confusing because you have to choose 0 for the first layer, 1 for the second layer, and it would get confusing. Now, I'm not going to show you how to, speaking for this entire audio file, as you can see, it's pretty long. This is just the intro and outro to this episode, but we will definitely go through some of this and I'll show you how to make your character speak. Let's set our first keyframe to 1. You don't have to come in here and worry about getting this exact, like in this time code here. You can just actually highlight it and click the number you want. So 1 is our resting shape. And then let's right click on this keyframe and we want to toggle hold keyframe. This mouth shape will not change until we get to the next frame. Hit the period on our number pad to kind of see what words we need to match our mouth shapes to.
Hey everybody.
So the first mouth shape is going to be hey, which is 2. And see, that actually takes care of our hey and our a.
Everybody.
So it's going to be an e. So let's highlight this and click 3. It's our v sound. So that's 10. So highlight that, 10. So we need an R, fifth layer. So B is going to be 9. That's body, so that's more like an A sound, like an ah. So we'll say 2. D is gonna be layer 6. So and, second layer. So we have D again, so it's gonna be layer 6.
Welcome back.
Welcome. So W is this eighth layer here. So it's L is about right here. And as you can see, we're not going to hit every exact sound, but you want to get ones that make sense to form the words. So L is 7. Come, so it's K, so it's going to be layer 3. M is going to be layer 9. Back, B is 9 also. So we'll leave that there. Maybe go for a little bit for the ah sound. Me too. And then K again is layer 3. Okay, so I'm gonna run through the rest of this real quick and just add in these mouth movements. But this is basically how you do it. I'm gonna add this into the Dropbox link for you to download this composition. So you have the character and you also have the mouth movements. And you can also feel free to save this project file and you can incorporate these into any of your animations and use what I have or kind of build on them and make something that works for your character. I hope this helped you out. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.